So it's 4:30 in the morning and Sawyer's puking everywhere. That's fucking perfect. Just... ugh.
I swear to God, dude, if you throw up on me, I'll make sure to throw up on you.
Oh, that's so silly.
So that was fun. Puking and all.
Oh, not just puking, liquid shit. It looked like a murder scene hit that toilet there.
Jesus Christ.
Like all around the rim, all the way down the side of the toilet.
The whole, all the way from the couch to the bathroom, he puked.
Oh. Chunks of fruit snacks still in it.
Jesus Christ.
What?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I'll wake up.
Yeah? What do you want to do? You want to eat some cereal?
No. I'll call you Super Bad.
From
80%
to
100%.
Doing
beds!
Nothing.
Nothing. They didn't even fucking flinch.
I'll go with you.
You want to go with me where?
With you, Dad. Are you, Dad?
What?
I'll go with you.
You don't want to come with me.
Yeah.
There's a big dog, and then we're going somewhere where there's no people.
Where are you going?
To a building.
So whose life did you save? Did you make him this plaque, Iris?
I'm all waiting, you know.
Driving all the way back to Comeuppence because I forgot to pack the drone controller, and of course it started raining now, so I'm hoping that when we get back there it's not still raining. Because it was not raining when we left his house.
Sun was out a little bit.
Sun was out almost. And now we're driving backwards into rain.
So it's coming my way.
Damn it.
That, seems to be the problem.
Ooh. Accidente. Come on, drive, good looking.
Tony's gonna do one of those face your fear moments where I'm gonna fly the drone and he's gonna run through one of the buildings that Gary screw and bolt. It's genuinely fascinating to me, the thing that's clearly happening in his brain that is affecting him physically.
I mean, I guess reindeer vest and the keeping you weighted to the ground aspect.
It's gonna work.
Yep.
Pulling up here to Gary screw and bolt, which is probably how you're gonna feel screwed, but then you're gonna have to bolt.
Yep.
Oh, look at this guy. He didn't even wear a hat. He is conquering fears today, folks.
Look down and run, man. Craziest thing I've ever done. God damn it, it's the biggest out of all of them, too.
You'll notice the male Anthony gets very quiet and almost stern in his replies as he approaches a difficult task. Something that his brain is not ready to wrap itself around.
Not at all.
Hello, tire yard.
March 26th. 5 minutes till 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and I'm gonna try to see if we can't conquer this place here. I'm gonna go for it, see what happens, see if I float away. Here I am. Anybody that knows me very well will know that I'm terrified of tall buildings, and especially tall ceilings. Obstacles here and there, some tires, some clothes. I got my beers strapped to my chest to weigh me down so I don't float away. The drone's gonna follow me through. Attempting to conquer this fear, so we'll see how it goes.
This was his path. I mean, I have to walk it in flip-flops now, which is not particularly awesome. However, he made it through, so I can't complain too much. So there he is all the way down there. Today is a different day than yesterday, folks. Yesterday he was clinging onto Mark's arm. Today he ran through himself.
So there's Joel going back inside to do some droning. I just conquered this building right here. I just ran right through it. It's a long way up them ceilings. Whew. It's a shame that
this doesn't bother anybody else that I know or have met, but this just bothers me so bad. As to do what Joel's doing right there, I think my skeleton would jump out of my skin and run out of the building. It's tough. Altocellophobia, they call it.
Our little friend is tucked away, sleeping in some far-flung galaxy, breathing like a baby concertina. And foxes are fighting, congregating in the garden, trying to choose a leader. Two pairs of eyes watch satellites dance between the clouds, and there's no chance they're coming down. At least we know it. I'm alone. Lay your weight on my shoulder and your hands on my backbone until it feels like we're almost past the point of no return. Sunset dashes across your cheek where splashes of color meet, a mix into a maelstrom just beyond the point of no return. Familiar vitriol is filtering through walls and window panes, then drowned out by the train, on the lost commuter, and everything is slow, and you look like a phantom in the glow from your computer. Two pairs of eyes watch satellites blink between the clouds, and I don't think they're coming down. At least we know we're on alone. Shoulder and your hands on my backbone until it feels like we're almost past the point of no return. Sunset dashes across your cheek where splashes of color meet, a mix into a maelstrom just beyond the point of no return.
All right, we just finished up a little bit of droning on the back side. Now we're gonna go front side.
I guess we're walking back through, or not, or are we going?
Well, what's straight?
Straight is through one of these buildings. I mean, that's not ideal for you, right?
Probably not.
I wouldn't think so.
Is this the one with all the pillars?
I believe so, yeah.
Oh, it has to be, because all the clothes is to the left.
Yeah.
And I have no flashlight on me. And this couldn't possibly be more of a longer walk.
Right, I think we are at the absolute furthest back.
Yeah.
So, our options are thusly. We could try to walk through this, or we could hug the wall and go out the back on that side as soon as we can get out.
Yeah, okay.
You want to do that? Just going to stay right here.
Yeah, we're doing some wall hugging. Now, what am I going to do in there?
We're gonna hug the wall, so we're gonna go right out the back.
Okay.
As soon as we can. Look at Braveheart here. He is. Well, they didn't really give us an out the back very easily. Sorry about that. I mean, we're gonna have to just kind of hug the wall again, if that's helpful in any way.
Yeah, it helps a little bit. Just move quickly.
I'm assuming it's better than.
A lot of graffiti in here.
Walking out in this. There's a door straight ahead of us.
Watching for our quickest out. Watching for nails.
You might have an out. Yeah, you do have an out there. You all right?
Yeah.
You gonna be able to get up that? Or are you just staying down there to hug the wall? Because there's no, you can't get back up over here necessarily.
Well, can I get out over there or no?
You can get out over, through there.
There's no other exit. Oh, there's the steps right there.
Well, yeah, I mean, we have that exit, but I didn't know if you wanted to walk all the way around.
This is what we're dealing with.
Can you?
not digging it.
Is it rusty nails? Ouch.
Okay, camera?
Hammer? Oh, camera. Like, hammer? What the fuck do you want a hammer for? Just busted my head on some rusty metal.
Did you hit your head on that?
Yeah, I just bumped it. I mean, that looks like an exit.
It looks like an exit, but we're gonna go. We're going for it. Look at this.
Oh, but that's where we want to be more. Unfortunately, I know you.
I had the guts to go.
I know.
And good job.
Look at that.
I think this is where we want to go. Yeah.
It's quite a.
All right. Well, mini adventure.
After being in that room was kind of like nothing.
Yeah. Oh, you mean the one with the tires? See, but that's the whole point, I think, with callousing you to this whole experience, is that hopefully it'll be that. It'll be, oh, compared to that other thing.
Another end to another adventure. I did what I said I was going to do.
Would you be willing to, for us to go find that bench?
Oh, that's fine.
It's a nice in and out mission there. The short ones can be nice as well.
Whose court apartment? Dune's court. What you doing? Finally turning, or finally going north at the end of
I-65.
Yeah, 65. Wow, it's pretty interesting so far.
Car check.
Is that what that is?
Yeah, right
here. So we'll just have to turn around somewhere.
Welcome to Robinson Lake, John Robinson Lake. Place that I used to come to all of the time when I was little to go swimming, go fishing with Grandma Jean. Now the beach is all gone. Pretty sure it's just grass. Wow, all the sand is gone. All the sand.
Right, both of us wearing white shoes here.
Yeah.
This is where people come to get murdered, or go to get murdered. Like, hey, excuse me, can I please get murdered? I'd like one murder, please.
People are coming here.
Go here. Okay.
There used to be a ledge of sand all the way around it.
Yeah.
It's just eroding away now.
Is this beer one of the day?
Two.
Beer two already? I didn't even see the first one.
Four. Well, I drank it at when I finished Victorious, and it was my last through that building.
Oh, you did that at Dairy Screw and Bolt. Okay.
Yeah.
What a haul. Holy shit. I mean, I always knew that that's sort of what it was going to be, that we'd have to walk all the way around, but fuck, we could have parked right there. That's weird.
Yeah, that looks great. Oh, this is the one view that I've never seen of Robinson Lake, up close, that is. Always from the expressway, but never actually down on. It's a hike to get over here.
You say you saw something in the surface of the neighbor's pool. I feel your fear, so I fake my cool. I tell you that it's just regrets reflected, and black is nothing more than silhouettes connected. Forget the retrospective, I promise in the future you will be protected. And I'll be calling home to let you know you're
was wearing white sneakers and jeans.
I'm not wearing white jeans. Do they make white jeans?
White sneakers?
Because I will wear white jeans if they make white
sneakers. White sneakers jeans. And jeans. Not white sneakers, white jeans.
This looks like every single horror movie I've ever seen.
Mini adventuring done.
back to Crown Point to pick up the wife and go to the grocery store for another adventure of food buying, of the food buying variety.
There's not many places that I go that are with the wife. Grocery. We need to get food. We need to get food though.
Hey, don't forget we gotta take out River's car seat for her first sleepover.
Oh, yeah.
Her first sleepover with Mabel. River, are you having your first sleepover?
Yeah.
Where are you gonna have a sleepover with?
Mabel.
Yeah. Are you going with Mabel?
Yeah.
It's pretty damn nice out this evening. Jen and I just hanging out. River is on her first sleepover at Allison's parents' house with Mabel. So she's already asleep, which is interesting, and Echo is being whiny. Can I go in a sec?
All these memories in my mind, my mind, my mind, my mind, my mind, my mind. I'm still a secret lemonade drinker.